I have a pink saber. You are so jealous. Last time I told you that I was a massive Star Wars geek. You need to understand just how big of a Star Wars geek I am. When I was a child, I saw Return of the Jedi and I fell in love with all of it. Then I became obsessed with the other movies. I had Barbies. I wasn't like totally into them though. I was totally into Wonder Woman and Star Wars. I would wear a Wonder Woman costume while playing with my Star Wars action figures. And I had all of the action figures, you guys, like you don't even know. I had the AT-AT, the Millennium Falcon, the Ewok Village, Jabba's Palace. Oh, I had this one lightsaber that glow in the dark, glowed. It glowed. And it had like holes for air to go through, so it went whoo, whoo. And I used to poke my sisters in the buttocks, as you do. I was completely obsessed with Star Wars. My obsession has only grown more and more as I've gotten older. How did this glittering girly girl come out of being a Star Wars geek? You guys, Star Wars is glamour, a glamour. The women of Star Wars are bad. This is what I kind of identified with as a child. Princess Leia kicked some serious butt. But then you go back and every single woman in the Star Wars universe is rad. Rad. And I loved that about what George Lucas created. I loved that he created these like strong, independent, I don't need some dude to take care of me kind of women. And to this day, like all of the women, especially now with like Rey and Jin from Rogue One, they're really awesome. And I think they're fantastic role models. Those women really informed who I became. I loved that Princess Leia was not just a princess. Princess Leia became a general, you guys. She kind of saved the butts of the guys. The other thing that I loved about Star Wars, which ties into my other love of the Muppets, were the Muppets' involvement in Star Wars. Who is my favorite character other than Princess Leia? I'm going to say Salacious Crumb. He's the little guy who sits in Jabba's tail and goes, ah! I don't know why I identify with him at all. All of this background of Star Wars that I'm giving to you is leading up to this extravaganza, the Star Wars Celebration. 4 days of Star Wars. And the thing that was so special about this celebration, it's the 40th anniversary of Star Wars. What? So I knew that this celebration was gonna be amazing. I was not prepared for how amazing it was.
So it's the first day of the Star Wars convention and I am going in. The line is like super, super long, but because I'm fancy and a VIP, see, I had to go in without waiting.
There's so much that happens at the Star Wars celebration. The main thing is this giant hall that is all merchandise. Stuff you can buy, stuff you can sell, collectors, really cool like clothing lines. I bought a ton of stuff, t-shirts and dresses and bags. The amount of Star Wars that you can buy is outrageous. I was totally prepared for what I wanted to see and do every single day of the Star Wars convention. But there are some very big panels that you have to get into. There were two important events. The first one was the 40th anniversary panel. You knew that there was gonna be like all of the stars from the original trilogy were gonna be there, and then surprises galore. The second major panel was the Last Jedi panel. What everybody wanted to see was the trailer. The 40th anniversary panel was so amazing. First of all, George Lucas comes out. Then a lot of the original cast comes out. Then Mark Hamill, Luke Skywalker, comes out and you're like, okay, this is the biggest like star of the panel. Then they go, you know what? There's somebody missing. And everybody went, ugh. And they talk about Carrie Fisher a little bit, but then they say, and then there's one more missing. And you're like, who's not here? Harrison Ford walks out. Okay, you guys, Harrison Ford has never been to a celebration. This was massive. And you had 20,000 geeks like me crying that he came out and was there. And it was amazing. So then, as they're all there, they're like, you know what? We need to do a tribute to Carrie Fisher. We're already crying. So then Carrie Fisher's daughter comes out, says the whole thing, and then they go, ladies and gentlemen, as a tribute to Carrie Fisher, they point this way, a pink curtain falls, and they go, John Williams and the Orlando Pops. You guys, it was one of the most incredible things I have ever seen. And I was like, good luck topping this. So I went VIP the first day. I was VIP the second day. However, to get into the room where it happens, to get into the room to see the Last Jedi panel was literally harder than getting Hamilton tickets. Even if you were a VIP, you had to show up at like 4:30 and go and wait in line to get a wristband. And all your VIP badge did was give you like a shorter line.
It's 5:30 a.m., the crack of ass. I'm in line waiting to get into the building to then probably wait in more lines to get a wristband to see a panel about the new movie, The Last Jedi, and they're gonna premiere the trailer. Some people slept in sleeping bags in like a giant hall, like crazy people. I walked through that hall yesterday and it smelled like people had slept there all night. I will say though, it's 5:30 and I did manage to put a little sparkle on my eyes because it's never too early to sparkle.
So finally, we get into the Last Jedi panel.
We're in a giant ballroom.
Let's see if we can do another one.
Waiting.
There we go.
The trailer.
Seeing a Star Wars trailer with 20,000 other Star Wars geeks at the same time and you're the first ones to see it is unbelievable. And there's nothing like it. So that was worth it. Apart from the stuff that happens during the day, there's also stuff at night. Dinners and organizations have their meetups and stuff.
We're at a fancy dinner, and it's so fancy that we're still in our sweats from the day.
You guys, the Star Wars party is exactly what you think it's gonna be.
One of the nights was at Disney Hollywood Studios, and it was called Galactic Nights, and it was all Star Wars fans, and the entire Disney Hollywood Studios was like Star Wars-esque. All of the drinks, the cocktails had like Death Stars in them. I had quite a few Death Stars. Quite a few. To just be at Disney with Star Wars fans was awesome. Shout out also to any of you guys that came up to me that night, because that is rad to find like Star Wars nerds and Broadway nerds uniting, and you guys found me at Disney World. It's awesome. So that was super fun. So shout out to you. The thing that I love about the Star Wars convention is that like there's no judgment. Everybody who's there loves Star Wars as much as I do, and people can have these awesome costumes or just walk around with a lightsaber in normal clothes, which is what I did. You know what was so cool? Where people were dressed in Star Wars costumes, but then there's a whole subset of people who, I don't even know what you call it. It's like a mishmash of characters. Like, they do Belle, but Slave Leia, so she'd be Belle Leia. It was really cool. Star Wars has always, always encouraged people to be who they are. That's a huge thing for me, because I'm always telling you vloggies, be who you are. Star Wars really, really, really drives that home. It is a universe of diversity. Alien, human, different colors, it doesn't matter. The only two things that differentiate people in the Star Wars universe is good versus evil. Am I gonna go to the next one? Absolutely. If you don't subscribe You're going to be missing out on a lot of really, really cool stuff.
You should click the thing.
Subscribe!
Please just subscribe and that's all.